A check valve is an amazing little device that lets a liquid or a gas flow one way only. We'll need some to make a low-cost water pump, but buying them can be a little pricey. So in this project, we'll be making our own, out of common materials, and for less than a dollar. For this project, I'm using a 3/4-inch male PVC slip adapter, 3/4-inch tubing, a 3/4-inch plastic ball, and an O-ring. I chose this adapter because there's a little ledge on the inside where the O-ring can sit, and it should look like this. The ball needs to be large enough that it won't push through the throat, but small enough that it doesn't touch the sides. Attaching the tube at this point won't really do any good because the ball will roll right out. We need a way to secure it in position. So let's make a mark on our tube 5/8 of an inch from the bottom and use a 16th inch bit to drill a small hole in the tube, continuing right on through the other side. Now you'll need a strong piece of metal, like a nail or a thick paper clip. I'm using one of these brad nails that go to my nail gun. Whatever you use, it needs to be strong and long enough to push all the way through the tube. The ends of the nail will need to be flush with the sides of the pipe, so we can go ahead and clip the end with the nail head on it, and now we've got ourselves a retaining bar that's perfectly flush on both sides. The next step is to prime our connections and place the O-ring in place inside the adapter. Now let's drop in the ball and double check that everything seals properly. PVC cement is added to the pipe, making sure it covers the holes where the nail is set. Then the pipe is pushed down to the point where the holes dip just below the rim of the adapter, so that when the glue sets, this connection will be completely airtight. You can build this valve into any length of PVC pipe you want, but I'm using this 1.5-inch piece because it's just long enough to accept another adapter. When it's glued and pushed together, it makes a nice little compact unit with only a slight gap separating the two ends. I took the opportunity to make 4 of these valves, and a visual inspection on the inside shows that the ball and O-ring are still seated properly in place, and the retention bar is keeping it all together. To finish up, I gave these a quick paint job and wrapped one end with a bit of electrical tape to indicate the direction of flow, similar to the marking you'd find on an electrical diode. A fluid can pass freely in one direction, but if the valve is turned around, the pressure closes the valve and the fluid is blocked. The quality of the seal can be tested by dipping the pressurized valve in a bowl of water. This will show us if any air is escaping at all. The pressure can be released though by pushing up on the inside of the valve to break the seal between the ball and the O-ring. I tried using a couple of these valves to make a hand pump, which you'll be able to find in another project. It'll compress air and move water at over 5 gallons per minute. You can even create enough suction to form a makeshift vacuum pump. The threaded ends of the valve make them easy to connect, replace, or rearrange whenever needed. Just for curiosity, let's pressure test the valve by hooking it up to an air compressor using this pneumatic adapter that we made in the rocket rifle project. The system's set at 20 psi, and you can see the valve close off and prevent any air from leaking. When I crank it up to 50 psi, the pressure difference is a little more obvious by the compression of the O-ring, and I'm really impressed at how well it works. As an alternative, I found that a rubber bouncy ball could replace the entire valve mechanism for low pressure applications. Since the ball is rubber, you don't need an O-ring to seal the port. To make it work, just grab a sharp knife and a cutting board and begin cutting the top third of the ball very slowly until you've sliced right through it. Now reinsert the ball with the round side facing down and simply slide the tube in over top. Amazingly, it's that easy, and my kids use it for blowing up balloons. Well, there's how to make some useful pressure-rated check valves for as little as 35 cents. If you like this project, perhaps you'll like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com.